Ivory Sickles Power Stance, Queen's Crescent Crown, but you can use whatever increasing headpiece that you'd like. I'm running with the Juvenile Scholar robe, but you'll see me switch between different robes just because I wanted to stay at light load. If you don't want to stay at light load, just run with whatever. We'll be using Stargazer Heirloom, Rotten Wing Sword Insignia, Millicent's Prosthesis, Erdtree's Favor +2, Glasgow Wondrous Physique. I'm running Magic Shrouding Cracked Tier and Thorny Cracked Tier. For stats, you'll be level 125, your Vigor will be 55, Dexterity at 49, Intelligence at 53. If you're more PvE oriented, just go for 50 Vigor and put the rest of the points in a Dex or Int. With that, let's get into the fight so you can see my hair gets real fucked up. Let's go. My thoughts on the Ivory Sickles. I like that the weapon itself takes design elements from Nicola's Hallig Tree and incorporates it into a weapon. That's pretty cool. But otherwise, I don't really recommend the weapon. It and Crystal Knife seem to have been overlooked by the developers, or perhaps they intended it to just be like a cool little offhand weapon. But because you cannot infuse them and you can't buff them, they're sorely lacking, especially in the dagger category, which is already one of the weaker weapon types in the game. I can really only recommend it for challengey runs or role-playing runs, because the Ivory Sickle and the Crystal Knife are simply objectively worse than any of the other daggers. Next up, we'll have the Scorpion Stinger, so that's going to be a fun little break after using Ivory Sickles. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.